I'm going to say a few things here that I doubt very much I could have said publicly a decade ago. Those years were an angry, censorious time. So, yes, people here suffered terribly on 9/11, but not anywhere near as terribly, and certainly much less stoically than a lot of other countries have and are even now. On 9/11, America basically declared that everything, literally everything, had just changed. It's more than any other nation make the rest of the world feel their pain. There are the obvious examples, such as invading another country and unleashing pure hell based on either massive incompetence or an even bigger lie. Saddam Hussein had no weapons of mass destruction and was not behind 9/11, but most Americans thought otherwise, and their government encouraged that falsehood. One estimate recently put the number of Iraqis who have died in suicide bombings at 12,000, making them greater victims of that particular atrocity than any other people, never mind the uncounted thousands of them killed by American troops. That's a pretty dear price to pay for something you had nothing to do with in the first place. Now, Americans made one another feel pain, too. With the national media here effectively cowed, government tossed basic freedoms out the window. It was a time of fear. Privacy shriveled. Sinister plots were everywhere, or so we were told. Traveling by air became a trip to the dentist. And the society that practically invented free speech imposed a deep chill. Dissent became plain unpatriotic. Civil libertarians were terrorist lovers. And most media here either cheered or surrendered, not to government threats, but to the collective paranoia of their own readers and viewers. Now, 10 years on, sanity has in large part returned. The war on terror now sounds like the cheap propaganda slogan it always was. Even the military doesn't use that one anymore. U.S. courts have curbed the government's worst secret excesses. The current president made torture illegal again. And most serious news outlets have rediscovered the virtue of speaking truth to power, or at least trying to. I'm glad of that because I'm quite fond of this country. If there has to be a dominant world power, better America than some of the other places I've worked. But I do look at this place differently than I did back in the day. American democracy is just a fragile veneer, and 9/11 proved that. There are indeed enemies out there, but authoritarianism always stands ready to impose its agenda from within. And a frightened public will let it happen. For The National, I'm Neil MacDonald in Washington.